for this service?
Sir, I got selected last year and currently I am on extraordinary leave. So I will be joining the training in August.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Last year you joined and then took EOA.
Yes, sir. Sir, the extension was supposed to be provided before joining the foundation course. So I did take the EOA before the foundation course.
And when is your interview?
Sir, it is on 24th of March.
Okay. Yes. Tell us about yourself.
Sir, my name is Arushi Mishra. I come from Rai Bareli, Uttar Pradesh. My birthplace is Prayagraj. Sir, I completed my graduation from IIT Roorkee. And it was in metallurgical and material sciences. And currently, I have been selected as the Indian Forest Services in the Indian Forest Services. And sir, I am pursuing the civil services right now. And in my free time, I love to read comics and
comics and swimming.
Yes, sir. Swimming I used to do when I was in college, but right now I do not get much time, and there is no avenue as such to do so. So I wish to do that after I get settled.
And I find from your application you are only applying for IPS, IAS and maybe revenue services, that's all?
Yes, sir. Sir, when I was filling up the draft form, I was apprehensive about filling the services, and when I talked to the seniors, they told me about writing the Indian Revenue Services as well. But now I have made up my mind that I will be joining Indian Forest Services if I am not allotted IAS or IPS.
Okay.
Yes.
So revenue you may not, or you will not join.
Sir, I am greatly indebted that I am already in the Indian Forest Service, so I might not join. Sir.
Okay. So tell us the reason why you want to not join IAS or IPS over IHS. What are the advantages that you think these two services provide you over IHS?
Sir, firstly, why I wanted to join it, because it has been a dream, sir. So it's because I come from IIT Roorkee and the 2009 civil services topper, Ms. Shubhra Saxena, was my senior. So, and currently she is posted as a district magistrate of my home district, Rai Bareli. So, sir, it has been a source of continuous motivation, and she told me, and I have got to know that this prestigious service provides me a very good career option. Apart and above from that, a life of satisfaction where I can impact more number of people positively. So, sir, I think that I was trying, so I should continue with trying this service.
Okay, very good. And you are from Rai Bareli, very happy.
Yes.
The state of UP.
Yes, sir.
So tell us about Rai Bareli. Has it grown after big names took part in the election process this time?
Sir, Rai Bareli has been growing a lot. Sir, whenever I visit my hometown Rai Bareli, I see considerable changes coming up. Sir, in the education sector, many colleges have come up. For example, Firoz Gandhi Institute of Technology and Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Petroleum Technology. And currently, sir, AIIMS is also coming up. And many of the international brands have opened their showrooms in Rai Bareli. And even, sir, in the infrastructure sector, since it falls in the heritage art belt of Uttar Pradesh, it is being, the construction over this sector has been really large, because the flyovers and the buildings and the hotel have been constructed.
Some coach factory?
Sir, it is the modern rail coach factory, I should have mentioned. I forgot to. And sir, and apart from that, sir, recently it has come up in the news regarding that one Ramsar site have been selected. Sir, it is
a some more big projects, big token projects are slated for Rai Bareli. So which are those?
Sir, as of my knowledge, I knew about AIIMS and the modern rail coach factory. Apart from that, sir, smart city was planned for Rai Bareli. However, it did not qualify when compared to Meerut, and it lost. So, sir, it is a dream of Rai Bareli to come into the coveted group.
Okay, and your state is also in some interesting discussions these days for name and shame.
Yes, sir.
Putting up the posters. What is your thinking on putting up the posters of all the writers?
Sir,
is it you, according to you, you go by High Court, or you think they are going to Supreme Court to justify?
Sir, I personally respect and go by the opinion of the Honorable High Court of Uttar Pradesh, because sir, mere accusations cannot be a reason for putting up the posters, because it violates the right to privacy as pointed out by the High Court. And sir, if at all it is there, then the Supreme Court decision on it should have been followed, that after the High Court or any other court convicts the person, then a process can be started in a better way rather than naming and shaming, sir, because it can lead to the violation of privacy and law and order issues as well.
Then on what ground the UP government has decided to approach the Supreme Court?
Sir, the UP government is saying that they have the right to do so, because they have been vandalizing the public property, and they think that the executive should be given this right to declare who has been the prime accused because of the pictures that have been caught in the camera. So sir, I think that this is the basis where Uttar Pradesh government is approached.
Okay, we recently celebrated International Women's Day.
Yes sir.
Why on 8th March, why not earlier or later? What is so significant?
Sir, the significance of 8th March particularly comes from a day in Russia when before the First World War, the Russian women came out on the streets asking for bread because of the inflation that was there in Russia. However, sir, the history of International Women's Day dates back to 1902, where in America, in Poland and every other country, the women have been mobilizing regarding wages and work and right to vote. But sir, the 8th of March particularly comes from Russia.
And maybe the first woman pilot was appointed on 8th March 1907.
Thank you, sir.
Check out on the name.
Thank you, sir. I will check.
Okay. And why there are very few women in science? And can you name some Nobel Prize winner women in science?
Yes, sir. The first thing that why women are less in science, it is because of many factors. So primarily because of the socialization factor that women feel, that in my family have felt that women are usually promoted towards subjects like arts and humanities, and my family being the only one that supported a girl in science.
I saw that.
Yes, sir. So that is a personal thing that I noticed also. And apart from that, sir, there are lesser avenues to work for women in science, because the graduating percentage or the girls who are getting graduated in science is increasing in India. However, due to familial or the societal compulsions, they do not find a very good job because it is very often demanding. So it is for the reason that they get graduated in science, however, they do not work in scientific fields. So sir, this is the problem, but it is changing, because now I see in my own district as well that many of the girls are taking up to good institutions and going into science.
And what about Nobel Prize winners?
Sir, Madame Curie is the...
How many times she won the Nobel Prize?
Sir, I think that it is 2 times, but I am not very sure about it.
Any other name? The lady who... invented plasma?
I'm sorry sir, I'm not able to recall a Nobel.
Okay, let's come to your metallurgy.
Yes sir.
And sociology. Your father is a lawyer, mother is a teacher. Sociology is an optional you have taken. So let's talk about mining in India.
Yes sir.
Can you tell me how many underground mines are there in India?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm not aware of the exact number.
Okay, tell me about iron ore and coal mines.
Sir,
the total deposits of iron ore and coal in India.
Sir, I'm not aware of the total deposits. I know that they are being found in the Gondwana region of India, that is situated in Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, and Odisha specifically. And sir, the better quality of coal is also found in the Jammu Kashmir region of India, that the anthracite coal. And regarding iron ore, sir, the potential of India is much, and it has huge reserves when it comes to iron ore. And India is currently pursuing aggressively towards becoming the iron ore exporter of the world.
More than 9,000 million tons of iron ore reserves are there in India. Okay, tell me about the new mineral policy of government of India. Just salient points with respect to the environment.
Sir, first of all, that the government of India has declared the minerals mining as an industry. So more investment, apart from the fact that more investments will be coming, government is putting up stricter regulations regarding the environmental damage. It has also created a district mineral fund where the damage to the environment can be catered to in the specific pockets where the mining is done. Apart from that, sir, a mineral corridor, dedicated mineral corridor is also created, so that mining that are being done is fairly regulated and covered, and the passage of the mineral is through a specific corridor so that it does not pollute the residential areas as well. So, sir, in my understanding, I think that these are the provisions.
And what about the topsoil? Any judgment from Supreme Court? When you go in for underground mining,
yes, sir.
What should be done to the topsoil?
Sir, the Supreme Court judgment, I am not aware of it. But if it comes to my understanding, what should be done of the topsoil? Sir, there are many plant varieties, tree varieties that can be planted over the topsoil so that they reclaim the higher mineral content or the higher pollution content. And apart from that, sir, a lot of afforestation can be done. So that any of the pollutant that is settled on the ground or is leached to the soil is removed to the maximum extent possible.
If there were no animals,
yes, sir.
What will happen to humankind?
Sir, the humankind would move more towards the extinction, because every animal or any species that moves away from the food web, I think that this is the time that people should get aware, because it is leading to their extinction as well.
Okay, tell me about maximum governance, minimum government, with specific reference to the budget. Which of the budget recommendations are pointed to government's philosophy of minimum government, maximum governance?
Sir, the first thing that that comes to our mind is the recent income tax change slab that is changed. Sir, it is more towards the choice that is given to the middle class and the agency that is given, that one should be taking the exemptions or not. And it is more towards the governance and lesser towards the governmental regulations. Sir, apart from that, in the export sector also, the NIRVIK scheme is brought, where more of promotion to the good governance is sought, where the banking, the export credit is done. And sir, in the field of organic farming, also the Jaivik Kheti portal is strengthened, and warehousing receipts are linked to ENAM. In all these places, the intermediaries are being sought to lessen, and more of a transparent form of governance is there. And so the strengthening of Umang portal is also one of the mentions that was there.
Last question before I pass on to my friend is on your hobbies.
Yes, sir.
You said reading comics?
Yes, sir.
So what kind of comics do you read?
Sir, I read majorly Amar Chitra Kathas and the current comic strips that come into the newspaper, like Gagan and Bob's. And sir, digital comics I have been reading a lot, like...
So Amar Chitra Katha, you must have read Mahabharat.
Yes, sir.
Chitra Katha?
Yes, sir, I have read
Mahabharat. You have read?
Yes, sir.
So why was the war fought at Kurukshetra?
Sir?
Why Kurukshetra, according to what you read?
I do not exactly remember the story that was mentioned in Amar Chitra Katha. However, I have the idea why it was fought in Kurukshetra.
Okay, tell me.
Sir, because Kurukshetra is a specific area where the land isn't plain, and the armies can come front to front, and there a level playing field of war is created. And as per the Mahabharat, the world armies of the world were on the two sides. So that was a place where the armies can be there, the camps could have been created, the elephants and the chariots could have moved easily.
Where did you read this? What do you all think?
Sir, I have heard from my parents. Sir, I have heard from my parents and moreover in the history books.
Read more.
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay, what was your responsibility at Avanti Fellowship Program?
Sir, my responsibility was majorly in the mentorship by making the timetables of the children and by making them aware of the forms that are coming in the market so that they get into better educational institutions. And sir, it was majorly about mentoring the class 11 and 12 students, how that they should be motivated about studies and how they should plan their overall curriculum.
What exactly that foundation does?
Sir, Avanti Foundation is an entrepreneurship venture that is based in Mumbai. Sir, it provides guidance and coaching to the students of 11th and 12th. But sir, Avanti Fellowship Program that is mentioned, it was a mode of giving back to the society where the Avanti venture provided scholarship to children, meritorious children who were residing around the College of ITOG.
So what are the problem in education sector?
Sir, the problem in education sector have been mentioned. But sir, it is more of a process that India is undergoing. So currently that comes to my mind is the question that is asked regarding the outcome problem India is facing. So sir, the enrollment is higher and now the outcome is being focused in the primary sector. Sir, the pupil to teacher ratio has improved a lot, but now the quality of teaching is also being focused because it is a problem. And sir, in my state Uttar Pradesh also,
what should be the component of quality teaching?
Sir, I think teacher training is very important. And value education to the students as well as mentorship of the students along with teaching is a very important part of teaching that I think it should be there.
Okay, what about the content aspect?
Sir, content, in my opinion, the content should be very good. And the teachers who are getting selected by the government and by the private sector do have the capability. But the lack of motivation and the lack of monitoring at times lead to them not delivering to their own potential. So I think training and motivating them, the teachers as well, is the right thing.
How can they be motivated?
Sir, since my mother is a teacher and I have come to the idea how it should be done. So the motivation aspect in my school had been the teacher had their Saturday sessions where teachers were taught the digital medium and the interactive medium, how they should do it. And the monitoring mechanism was also there. And one class and one subject was provided where they can also innovate so that they become the stakeholder in the overall teaching curriculum, not the what the institution desires.
Okay. Have you heard about the aspirational district program?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you identify certain some districts in your state?
Sir, I should have known it, but I am currently not in a position to.
Okay, what are the key components of aspirational district program?
Sir, the key components is the convergence of the scheme that is being there in the aspirational district programs. All the central government and the state government schemes would be streamlined towards particular areas that need improvement. Apart from that, sir, the key performance indicators are marked so that there are 10 indicators per district that needs to be improved in a certain specific time. And apart from that, sir, it is about making the connect between the central government and the state government via Prabhari officers that are being made. So I think that this is an overall focus on the 112 districts that would be giving results in a time to come.
How is it different from other programs? Earlier, the government of India has launched many programs.
Yes.
But how is it different?
Sir, I think that it is a program that culminates all these schemes because government of India has been launching many number of programs and that they are targeted towards specific problems or specific sectors. And this is a program that targets all that culminates all the scheme into one for a targeted delivery of result. So I think in that aspect it is different. and the specific timelines and the specific performance indicators that it measures. So it is more of an outcome-oriented program.
Are we moving towards the right direction?
Sir, I think that India is moving towards the right direction.
No, but not with respect to aspirational district program.
Sir, I do not have the facts to support my answer. But I have read in the news that the aspirational districts have been performing really good when it comes to education sector and the health sector. And gradually the skilling is also done, and in a very industry comprehensive manner, the need of the industry accordingly. And sir, I think that India would be moving in the right direction with this program.
Okay, tell me a few challenges of aspirational district.
Sir, I think that the first challenge that evolves is we plan that the convergence of scheme has to be there. However, the parameters or the way of convergence might be a problem. Sir, the sectors that are to be focused needs to be clarified in a very comprehensive way.
Do you think it has not been clarified?
Sir, I think so it is, but it is a process where it would be taking more time for it to stabilize and culminate into a better and strong compartmentalization. Sir.
Okay, let's move on to international relations.
Yes, sir.
Okay, currently India has some problem with China.
Yes.
What are those problems?
Sir, India has problems with China that are many though. Sir, in the international level, India and China are the two big players, regional players that are aspiring to be the regional superpower. Sir, India and China also have border issues, and it is for that reason that India and China at times are at loggerheads with each other. But sir, and there have been problems regarding China's dumping of the products in India, especially the toys market and the medicine market. So, sir, these are the problems. And
is there any other good that has been dumping in India?
Yes, thank you, sir.
Any other good that has been dumping in India?
Sir, mobile can be one of the area where China is capturing Indian market. And for that, India is doing much. And recently, it has opened up a factory of Samsung in Noida.
Have you heard about iron industry dumping?
Yes, sir. I should have mentioned it.
Okay. Yes. So, what is the problem?
Sir, their cost of production is less as compared to Indian cost of production, and apart from that, sir, they are being provided with the export duties leaving. So India is producing at a higher cost than China. So, and India does not have any import control. India was not having the import control. Recently, it has increased the duty to 30%. So the Indian domestic industries were preferring iron and steel from the China and the South Korea.
What is predatory dumping?
Sir, predatory dumping is a form of dumping where export subsidies are given in the exporting countries so that the prices that are there in the importing countries are lesser as compared to the prices in the home country as well.
What is cost dumping?
I did not get the question.
Cost dumping.
I'm
or
sorry.
Price dumping.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm not aware.
Okay, Arushi.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so your option subject was sociology.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so tell me, is it essential to be socially correct or politically correct?
Sir, there cannot be a blanket opinion about one should be politically correct or socially correct. However, sir, if a person is socially correct, then it is usually bound to be politically correct because politics is always the reflection of the societal good. So I think that one should be socially correct as compared to politically correct.
Okay, one should be socially correct.
Yes.
If we compare it to politics.
Yes.
Okay. Very well. Okay. As a student of sociology, what social planning would you recommend for India's growth?
Sir, for India's growth, I think that I would be preferring. I would be focusing on all the heterogeneous sectors that India is made up of. For example, sir, in the skilling sector, if the young sector, young generation we see, there have been differences in the demands of all the youth of the country. So we need different kind of skilling for each sector. For the upper middle class and the higher class, there is a need to develop the hospitality sector and the IT sector and the engineering sector. And for the lower class, it needs to be developed more on the sides of semi-skilled workmanship and manufacturing industries and the blue-collar workers. So for women also, the need of the hour is to shift from care economy to the economy of where more manufacturing and services sector. And sir, in my opinion, I think that the one very important segment that in the social planning we as a society miss is that the experience that the senior citizens of India have. The recently launched Anubhav portal by the Government of India, where the experiences of the senior citizens is being mentioned. I think that those experiences can be utilized in making step-by-step betterment in every sector that they have worked in.
How will you address the problem of growing aging population of India, of the world in fact?
Sir, I think that it has to be looked in a direction more like that it is not a problem, but it is a form of solution. It is more of a guidance that the youth that might be lesser in number, but they will be getting and the experiences that they are getting. And sir, it is more about that we improve the migration of the people from the young areas, and as well as improve the geriatric care and the experiences sharing of the senior citizens where they are in large numbers.
Capture their knowledge.
Yes, sir.
You seem to be very good in sociology. So
thank
one more question on sociology.
Thank
okay.
you. Yes, sir.
Which research areas of sociology attracts the brightest of minds?
I'm sorry, sir, I did not get
which research area
yes,
of sociology attracts the brightest minds?
Sir, I think that currently it is the crime sociology that is coming up, because the type of crimes and the niche crimes that are being developed that society is currently facing has been seeing the more amount of studies as I have gone through.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So let us move on to other areas of our DAF.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So hobbies. I mean, okay. So, what is your opinion about postponing or cancelling the Olympics amidst the fears of COVID-19?
Sir, as the fear of COVID-19 is rising and the pandemic is already declared, I think, sir, if the cancelling of Tokyo Olympics takes place, sir, it would be a very rational decision, because the pragmatism has to come before the idealism, and here the lives of people matters, because Olympic is a very large gathering where a lot of people come and interact. So we cannot be over optimistic about the fact that it would not spread. So I think that it is a rational decision.
And talking about the economic impact of the same,
yes,
do you think India is on the verge of another recession, or the entire world economy is on the verge of another recession?
Sir, definitely there are fears that the entire world economy is towards another recession. However, sir, there have been good news on some fronts, like the COVID-19 is coming under control in China and in the European nations and the Indian nation as well. The control has been decently good. And sir, the trade war that was there between the US and China has also come to phase one of the dialogue and partnership. So I think, sir, that the fears are rational, but there might be a possibility that we do not slip into the recession like 2008.
And what's your take on the current crisis of Yes Bank?
Sir, the Yes Bank crisis has been a regulatory problem, and it is more about, sir, the crisis can be seen on two fronts. The first, that there needs to be stricter regulation and monitoring of such kind of lending. So RBI might be given more powers, the current action of RBI should be implemented in a proper way. Apart from that, sir, there needs to be a check on the individuals who come to man such higher positions, because ultimately it is the responsibility of the people who are sitting in such higher positions to take right decisions, because they are entrusted to do so.
Board of directors.
Yes, sir.
Especially independent.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. why is it so that every year some new scam comes and we are always doing firefighting approach? Why are we not proactive in our approach to solve such issues?
Sir, I think that RBI and the government has been very proactive in solving the issues. But situations like Yes Bank or any other crisis often come, and it is beyond the planning. Everything cannot be planned, and many times only the preparation can be done, and exact planning cannot be done. So every time a new problem comes, the government or the RBI comes up with many solutions. But the system where a lot of people are interacting, a lot of companies are interacting, and the international markets are also interacting, there are bound to be new challenges. And for that, the firefighting is the solution that is there.
Okay. And you come from Uttar Pradesh?
Yes, sir.
Bundelkhand is in UP or MP?
Sir, Bundelkhand is a region that can be counted both in UP and MP. Sir,
let us say, if Bundelkhand is made a separate state,
yes, sir,
what would be the impact on a common man?
Sir, common man's impact is majorly derived from the economic aspect that it faces, that one faces. Sir, Bundelkhand if made as a state, has very less chances of becoming viable because of the fact that it is a dry area and it is not very rich agriculturally. And when we say that it has good amount of mineral resources, it needs time to utilize all these resources. So when it comes to a common person, it would not be a very good step, rather than being connected and being part of the era of the Uttar Pradesh, because now the defense corridor is coming up there, the expressways are coming up there. So I think that it is better for the common man that Bundelkhand remains the part of Uttar Pradesh as well.
And you come from a family where your mother is a teacher and father is a lawyer?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So tell me, is there any law where a woman can refuse to be arrested after 6 p.m. till 6 a.m. in the morning?
Sir, I am not aware of the law. However, I have read this provision. I think that it might be in IPC. But I am not sure about the law.
Before we wind up your mock, where did you go on this Himalayan Explorer Club trekking?
Sir, I have been to 3 places. Sir, as a part of Himalayan Explorer Club, I went to Nag Timba Trek and Valley of Flowers Trek. And recently, sir, I went to Manipur for a Shirui Valley Trek. So these are the 3 places that I have visited.
And what is your reaction on the environmental damage that has been caused by the trekking?
Sir, the environmental damage that has been caused is now being, the people are getting aware and the trekkers are even aware. Sir, the Himalayan Explorers Club that is mentioned, sir, it was by the club in college, and in college also we were not supposed to make loud noises or use floodlights so that we disturb the animals and the life there. And we were supposed to, every person was supposed to bring 2 kgs of waste while returning from the trails. So, sir, it was a club effort, and the recent the private companies that are coming up from trekking.
So you are conscious of?
Yes, sir.
What is this graphene?
Sir,
and its application. What is graphene and its application?
Sir, graphene is a material in metallurgical and material sciences. I got exposed to this material. So it is a material that is coming up in the market. It is the two-dimensional structure of carbon. And it is a revolutionary material in the sense that it is 2000 times stronger than steel. And even a whisker of, it is said that the whisker of graphene can support the weight of a cat itself. So it is a very strong material, and the researchers are going on so that we use it in mobile phones, in bulletproof jackets, in the airplane industry as well.
Have you heard of Mobian strip?
I'm sorry, sir, I have not heard about
it. Okay, we close your mouth.
Thank you.
We'll call you for.